For over a half a century, television has been the number one media outlet in shaping American culture. From sitcoms to reality television, the time Americans spend in front of screens peering into created realities is a time of more than just entertainment. It molds our views and inspires our decisions. Our perceptions of race and gender have been shaped by the images perpetuated throughout popular culture since the early 1800s. And television is the most recent and potent example. African Americans have been the target of stereotyping and racism since the era of slavery. Initially, the social constructions of blacks in America were created and propagated as justification for slavery. The demise of the antebellum South brought about even more images of African Americans in an effort to alienate and exclude blacks from the white society. Images such as the Mammy, the Sapphire, and the Jezebel, which were conceptually imported from Europe, have dominated society's vision of African American women in particular through the various media forms available over the century. The rise of television as a mass medium is no exception. In 1945, The Beulah Show became one of the first television series to prominently feature an African-American woman, casting Louise Beavers as a perfect representation of the mammy stereotype. Similar to her role in the film Imitation of Life 20 years earlier, Louise Beavers plays an overly subservient maid, portraying African-American women negatively, unable to function without their masters. Ethel Waters, who played Beulah in the first season of the series, quit the show because she was unhappy with the image she was portraying. In response to the civil rights movement, the show Julia began to air, which showed huge progression for the image of African American women. It starred Diane Carroll as the first lead African American woman role that didn't cater to stereotypes. Instead, Julia is a widowed mother who works as a nurse in a doctor's office. The show treated race as invisible, as if Carol were actually a white woman. Donald Bogle, a film and television critic, explained that some African American viewers saw her as being too much a conciliatory figure, a sellout. They were not wrong in their claims. In an interview, Carol stated that she took the role as Julia for money and power to afford herself freedom.
Be here at 9, and make yourself as handsome as you can manage. I'm tired of looking at ugly nurses. I married one.
I'll do my best, sir. But has Mr. Colton told you?
Tell me what?
I'm colored.
What color are you?
I'm a Negro.
You always been a Negro, or you're just trying to be fashionable?
Oh.
9 o'clock. Try and be pretty.
In the end, the burden of carrying African-American representation on television was too much for Julia, and in 1971, Carol asked for her contract to be released after 4 seasons. Through the next few decades, various television shows shared these responsibilities, some taking a progressive stance on black images and others falling back to the traditional stereotypes.
Well, we're moving on now.
Among these shows were The Jeffersons, Good Times, Give Me a Break, and later, Living Single, with The Cosby Show among the longest lasting and most successful. In modern day television, much has changed, but whether the representation of African Americans has is debatable. Joining the sitcoms of the late 20th century are drama and reality TV. In the past decade, shows of these genres continue representing African-American women as in the past. One recent drama, Empire, features Taraji P. Henson as Cookie. Cookie resists the stereotypes of the Sapphire and the Matriarch and has been well received by critics. She portrays African-American women in a positive light but still shows both the bad woman and the good woman sides. She is a fierce mom but expresses it as a ferocious love for her children. She's not above violence, having once tried to smother another character with a pillow and getting in fight with others. However, her character completely opposes the Jezebel image, being sexually confident enough to point out that she has only ever had sex with one man despite an early marriage. Shows like Empire create dynamic images of African-American women which differ from past portrayals. However, shows such as Empire can be criticized for propagating new drugs.
I'm gonna call you back.
Mass media has created a cultural hegemony on public opinion. Reality TV creates unquestioned truths out of cultural stereotypes. The Real Housewives brand shows women as unworthy and self-centered. The Real Housewives of Atlanta takes this a step further with a mainly black cast. It depicts black women as violent, having plenty of catfights, and backstabbing.
Want to go back to even Atlanta Housewives? If you look at them, the name calling, it's not black affirming, it's not sister affirming, it's not positive. When we look at some of the other television shows, some of the more popular shows like A Scandal or the other one, on Shondaland, How to Get Away with Murder, the women are beautiful black women, but when you see their actions and the things they engage in, it just really takes away from what it means to be a whole and complete African-American woman.
One incident of a fight between women caused Color of Change, an organization prompting black political voices to criticize the show for a pattern of violence. Stereotyping portrayals of black people across many of Bravo's black reality franchises. The show turns normal women into lunatics by manipulating social interactions behind the scenes when cameras aren't running.
We're not doing this.
That's why they
want to
be in that seat.
Don't do it, Portia. Listen to me. Portia, look at me. Don't do it. You hear me? We already had this talk.
I am not going to sit here and get hit by somebody on TV. I'm done.
Over the decades, television has inherited the historical representations of African-American women and repurposed them to various ends. Some shows, such as Beulah and the Real Housewives, perpetuate negative images of black women, while others, like Julia and Empire, seek to present a more dynamic and holistic view of black women in society.